Hey, what's going on, guys? I've got the Sigma 70 to 200 millimeter f/2.8 APODG HSM OS lens here that I wanted to do a review for you guys. It is a mouthful to say, but it is a pleasure to work with this lens. The 70 to 200 millimeter lens is a lens that pretty much any serious photographer should have in their arsenal, whether you're a portrait photographer or especially if you're a sports photographer. This is one of the best focal lengths and most versatile lenses that anybody could own. I use this probably about 80% of the time for my sports, or about 80% of the time overall, almost 100% of the time for sports photography. Occasionally I will take out a 300 millimeter whenever I'm shooting sports like football or soccer, but for the most part this is the lens that I carry with me because it is relatively small and lightweight. You notice I don't even have the tripod collar on here because I shoot this thing 100% of the time handheld. I know some people shoot a 70 to 200 on a monopod. To be honest with you, I feel like the monopod gets in my way. This thing is more than handholdable. I've used this thing to shoot all day long. At sometimes on Saturdays, I'll go out and shoot 5 or 6 football games in a day. I'll be out there for 8 to 10 hours shooting. And yeah, it gets tiring after about 8 to 10 hours, but for the most part, it's handholdable. The reason why I use this lens is because it is significantly cheaper than Canon or Nikon 70 to 200. I shoot on a Canon system. The newest Canon 70 to 200 millimeter lens will set you back somewhere around $2,200 to $2,500. This lens right here is about $1,200, brand new. I happened to pick this one up used off of Craigslist for a whole $600, and the guy had used it, he said, once, and that's what it looked like. This lens is, it's not small, it's not a huge lens, but it'll get some looks, it'll get some attention. This is the APS-C hood attachment. I guess if you're shooting on a full frame, you don't need that extra adapter, but you can see that it's a pretty good sized lens. Now you're not going to get the same image quality out of this thing as you will the Canon or Nikon. I'll be honest with you, I've shot with the Canon version and it is just a little bit sharper and it does focus just a little bit faster. But to be honest with you, unless you're really pixel peeping, nobody's ever gonna know the difference. I shoot with this, as I said, all the time, and I don't get any complaints about my photography work and I get plenty of business. Granted, it could be more, but I don't have a shortage of customers for either my sports photography or for my portrait photography. So obviously the lens is adequate to get the job done. At half the cost, it's worth it to me to make a slight sacrifice in image quality to save $1,200 to $1,800. The autofocus is just slightly slower than the Canon version. But most people will never notice the difference. And I'll be honest, the image stabilization on this isn't nearly as good as Canon's. I've kind of got a shaky hand, so I'm not the best person to talk about shooting at really slow shutter speeds. But with the Canon, I can easily handhold well below 1/30th of a second. With this one, 1/30th is about the limit, and it's not going to work every time for me. But it's a phenomenal lens for sports and portrait photography. You will find that it's more than sharp enough for you, and it focuses fast, which is one of the things that I love about these 70 to 200 millimeter lenses, because as a sports photographer, you've got to be able to reacquire focus as the ball moves around from player to player. You've got to be able to transition quick to get the shot, and these lenses definitely perform. One other thing I want to talk about that I use on occasion with this lens is I've also got the Sigma EX DG APO 1.4 teleconverter. Sigma makes everything very difficult to say. This just hooks right on between the lens and the camera body. It gives me an extra 1.4 reach. Now, for example, I'm shooting the 70-200. I've got it on a Canon 7D right now, so the lens is effectively a 320 millimeter lens. You slap this on, and now it's over 400. Math is not my best subject, so I'm not even going to try to do the conversion, but it gives you that extra reach when you're out shooting. I've heard a lot of people say that it slows the autofocus down a lot. It does slow it down some, but to be honest with you, it's hardly noticeable. The one thing that I did notice with the Sigma teleconverter combination is that the images are not as sharp wide open. With any zoom lens, you typically are going to find that if you stop your aperture down a stop, you're going to get sharper images. This one shoots adequately wide open at f2.8, but if I stop it down to f4, I get even sharper images. With the teleconverter on, there's a significant loss in image quality shooting at f4, which would be wide open because you lose one stop of light with the teleconverter on the lens. So the f2.8 lens becomes an f4. At f4, there is a pretty significant drop in image quality. If I drop it down to f8, I can get most of that back. It's still not as sharp as I'd like it to be. Unlike the Canon teleconverter lens combination, which you see virtually no You see no loss in image quality with the teleconverter lens combination. With the Sigma, for me personally, I see quite a big drop, but I still like to use this sometimes whenever I'm shooting on a bright day. For example, if I'm out shooting soccer where the field is just huge and this is the only lens that I have with me, I can slap this on. I can get the extra reach. Yes, the images aren't going to be as sharp as they normally would, but to be honest with you, the people who you sell them to will never notice the difference. When you talk about image sharpness, it's an issue for photographers, and to be honest with you, photographers don't buy other photographers' pictures. So photographers are the ones that are always critical about, oh, an image is a little soft. It amazes me how often I take a picture and there's someone in the photograph, maybe in the background, that's slightly out of focus, and then somebody wants to buy that image because the out of focus person is their kid. And as a photographer, it's frustrating to me because I want all my best, sharpest images to be of the person, whoever's buying the photograph. But so most people don't care. Pixel peepers are photographers, they're not the consumers. So yes, there is going to be a little bit of loss in quality, but it's not significant. It's not enough to ruin your images. It's still going to be sharper than a 70-300 millimeter kit lens. So anyways, I highly recommend this lens for anybody shooting who's on a budget. If you have the money, you want the absolute best quality, my recommendation is go ahead and go for the Canon or Nikon version. There's also a Tamron version out of the 70-200, which I have not tested, but from what I have been told by other people and looking at reviews online, it rivals the Canon and Nikon lenses in every way, that it is as good or better. But I haven't tested it, and again, it's running roughly half the price of the Canon or Nikon lens. So hopefully that'll help you out, and check out my other videos on telephoto lenses and other reviews. Thanks.